Hey everyone, my name is Abhishek and welcome to another episode of Creative Tuesdays. Today we are going to learn how you can link multiple properties with each other for easy control. It's very easy to do and it will save you a lot of time and effort. So before I begin, if you guys are new here, then please consider subscribing and make sure to press that bell icon so that you never miss another amazing video like this. So without wasting any further ado, let's jump into After Effects and get started. Alright, so right now I'm in After Effects and I've already created a composition to show you guys how this works. So over here you can see we have four different shape layers and all of them has this fill effect. And let's say you want to change the color of any of these layer. So let's say you want to change the color of this circle. So simply what you do is you select the layer, then you go under the effects and control panel and you can simply change the color from here. And in the same way you can do that for all the layers. Now what if you have hundreds of layers over here, then you cannot go to each layer and then select it and then change their color. So the better way is to have a single layer on which you can link all these properties so that you can control them from over there. Now this is also helpful when you are making templates for selling online or you want to give the project to your client so that they don't have to bother about each and individual layer. They can control all the necessary properties from a single layer. So in order to do that, we need a layer on which we can link all these properties. So the best way is to create either a null object or an adjustment layer. So I'm going to create a null object and we can probably hide this because we are not going to use this. So on this one, we are going to apply an effect. So if you can under the effects and preset panel, you can search for color control. And you can just simply drag this onto this layer. And right away you can see we have this controller which has this color property. So you can rename this. So select this, then press enter and you can type your name. Now we have this single color. So we have four layers. So I'm going to duplicate this four times. So you can select the layer, press control D to duplicate it. And I'm going to duplicate it two more times. So now we have the colors over here. And our last step is to link these properties to these colors. So the best way to do that is over here you can see we have this lock option. So we are going to lock this panel. So now I can click anywhere and this panel will not change. So in order to link the property, just simply select the layer and just search for the property that you want to link. So in our case, we have the color property. So you can see that under the fill, we have this color option. So you can link this by simply holding down the Alt key or Option key if you are on Mac. Then just simply click on this stopwatch and it will give you the area where you can type your expression. Now we are not going to type any expression. Instead you can select this pick whip option, then just simply drag it and just simply link it to the color. Now you can see that it has automatically typed an expression. Now you can see that if I change this color, you can see that the color over here is changing and this is pretty much what we want. Now if you want, you can leave this expression right away, it will work, but if you want to make this a better expression, then you can do this. So you can remove this last color option and instead of this you can just simply type 1 and now it will work just like before. So what's the difference between the two? So the main difference is that we all know After Effects comes in different languages and let's say you are making a template that you want to sell online and now people from all around the world are going to download the template. So when they download it and let's say their After Effects is in some other language, so let's say they are using it in Spanish. So you will notice that instead of one, we had the color written over here and in their version of After Effects, they will have a different name over here. So that will cause this expression to give us an error. So instead of typing the name, we can simply type one. So that means the first property in this option. Now in the same way, you can link the properties of other layers as well. Now just like the color control, we have different controllers so you can link different properties. So let's search for other controller. So we have the slider controller. You can see that all these comes under expression controller. So you can just simply open up all these and you can see that we have a bunch of them. So let's see how you can use the slider controller. So I'm going to simply drop this onto this layer. Now this controller is used to link any property which has this numeric slider. So let's say we have this layer. And if I press T, so you can see that we have the opacity property, and you can see that it also has the slider. So that means we can link these two with each other. So I can just simply select this, type opacity, and now you can alt click, then just simply select the slider, and again just simply replace the last name with one, and now you can see that its value is controlled by this slider. So if I increase it, you can see that its opacity is increasing just like this. In the same way, you can control other properties as well. So let me just duplicate this and let's control the scale of some other layer. Scale, and let's set this to 100. Now let's select this layer and you can press S for scale, and again hold on the alt key and then just simply click. Now in the same way, let's change the slider with 1. So now you can see that we are controlling the scale using this slider, just like this. So in the same way, you can link all the properties that you want using these controllers. There are a bunch of different controllers and all of them works the same. So let's say you want to link the position. So right away you can see that position has two parameters and this one also has two parameters. So you can do that. And in the same way, you can use all the other controllers as well. We have the angle controller. So let's say you have a radial property. So let's say you want to control the rotation. You can use this angle controller. And we have one of these checkbox controllers. So this is a very helpful controller if you want to create an enable button. So let me show you how you can do that. So we are going to select this layer, then press T for opacity, and we are going to link the opacity property. So if they enable this, then the opacity is 100, and if the checkbox is disabled, then the opacity will be 0. That means it will not be visible. So let's see how to do that. So again, you can hold down the alt key and then just simply click over here, and now you can see that it gives you a space where you can type an expression. Now we are going to type a small expression and it's very simple. So let me just quickly do that. So we are going to type if and then rounded braces, and under this we are going to pick whip this one, and again we are going to replace the checkbox with 1. Then we are going to add a greater than symbol, 0. And under the curly braces, I'm going to type 100. And again, curly braces close, then else. And again, under the curly braces, I'm going to type 0. So now first, let me show you how this works. So you can see that right away, it's not checked. So the opacity value is 0. And if I check this, so now you can see that opacity value is 100 and our rectangle is visible. So now let's understand this expression. So you can see that our expression starts with if. So we are telling that if this checkbox is on. So how we are telling it, you can see that we have the checkbox over here. So if you enable this, it will give you a value of 1, which is greater than 0. So that means we have checked this box. So if this box is checked, that is its value is greater than 1. That means that this will be true, then the value that it will give is 100. So you can see that right now it's 100. And if it is not greater than 1, that means that this box is not checked, then it will give us this value of 0. So that's why we have this else statement over here. So if I disable this, so you can see that now the value is, checkbox value is 0. So if the checkbox value is 0, 0 is not greater than 0, so this will not be our value, but else we'll get this value. And if I enable this, now the checkbox value is enabled, so that means it's 1. So if the checkbox value is 1, which is greater than 0, so this one is true, so it will give the 100 value and this part will not be executed. So it's a very simple if else statement, and this is how you can create the checkbox controller. Now there is one another way in which you can link the properties with each other. So let's say you want all of these three shape layers to have the same color as this rectangle. So in order to do that, what you can do is, so let's select this one. So this is the shape layer 4, and over here we can see that we have the fill effect. So I'm going to select the fill effect, then you can go under the edit, and from here you can see we have this option called copy with relative property links. So just simply click on this. Now you can select all the layers on which you want to control the property, then simply press Ctrl V to paste it. And now if I go back here, you can see that I can change all of their colors by simply using this color option from this layer. And not only this, I can also change all the other properties from here as well. So we have linked the fill effect on all of these layers with the fill effect in this one, so that we can control it from here as well. Now in the same way, you can control all the other properties as well. So let's say I want to rotate all of these layers as respect to this one. So what I can do is I can select the rotation property, and then again you can go to edit, copy with the relative property links. Then we can select all the rotation properties, and either you can go and paste it or you can simply press Ctrl V, just like this. So now you will notice that if I rotate this, you can see that all the other shape layers are rotating as well. So this is how you can link multiple properties with each other. So I hope you learned something from this video, and if you guys have any query or question, you can ask me in the comments below. Also, if you are new here, then please consider subscribing, and also make sure to press that bell icon so that you never miss another amazing video like this. So with that being said, my name is Abhishek, and I'll see you in the next one.